Good evening, everybody. Crazy Russian 86 here, and welcome back to another video. Today, when I was in one of the facilities, I talked to one guy. The guy is Christian, very nice man, obviously. He's been telling me that, you know what, he was not saying that I need Jesus, but he was saying, you know what, I used to get angry about things and we all sinners. But you know what? Once you accept the Jesus in your heart, the anger is going to go away. And you know, a couple weeks ago, I watched some video in Russian. It was also about the teachings of Jesus Christ. You know, it's about the man, his name was Paisi, and how that guy was, you know, he was like a famous healer. He was helping a lot of people. He was very interesting individual because he was famous for his ideas of not enforcing anything on anybody. Like, he had very good stories. Like, one of them is, for example, one man went to him and said, you know what, I'm a sinner, I have a wife, but I've been cheating with another woman, and I have two sons, and that guy knew everything. And you know what that Paisi said? He didn't tell him, you know what, you're so bad, don't cheat on your wife, how dare you. No, he said, your son's going to be there in town, so don't go to that hotel where you usually go, because they're going to find out, cheat with her elsewhere. And another story I like was very interesting too. There is a woman and she had a son who was a smoker. So she decided to take the guy to that guy, you know, to Paisi. And she was thinking that he's going to make him stop smoking. So, but then time was passing by and he was still smoking. So she went to him and asked him, why did you, I wanted you to make my son stop smoking. Why is he still smoking? And the guy said, you know what? It's a good thing he's just smoking. Because if he wouldn't be smoking, maybe he will hurt some people. Maybe he will kill someone. And he'd been talking about, like, you know, there are some people who kill, like, let's say, one or two people, right? And people say, oh, these people are so horrible. And he's like, think about it. Do you know that these people who killed one or two people were actually thinking of about killing like 100 or 200 people? You know? And that's why, like, you know, when I learned a little bit about Christian philosophy, which I never learned about it in Jewish school, I never watched videos like that. I just came across it on YouTube. So liberating. And it's like, you know, you can say, oh, you know what? These Christian people, they allow sin, they allow evil. But this is not the point. The point is, they allow people be as they are. They're not trying to change human nature. Because they know that this is impossible. And when I was watching that video of that guy in Russian, I was like, oh my God. I wish my Jewish parents would teach me like that. So I would feel bad. But now people are making me feel bad. And I'm always feeling bad, you know, because I'm acting out. And you know, I've been acting out in a lot of facilities sometimes, I'm not gonna lie. But you know what? When people acting funny and people acting stupid, that makes me wanna act out. Because like, I don't like when people treat me like that. Like, what the fuck? I don't like to feel like I'm being evaluated. I don't like when people ask me stupid questions, which they know the answer, which I know the answer. You know, like I've been having a lot of weird shit going on in my life. People are saying and the calling me spurg, this or that. First of all, I said so many times, it doesn't matter. It's not going to change anything. Leave me alone. Be a Christian. And that's the right philosophy. And then that guy was also talking about, you know, this guy was in that facility. Very nice guy, by the way. He was talking about Jesus being Son of God who died for our sins. Which, you know, my Jewish parents, they passionately hate our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ or Yehoshua. And I'm more like a Christian mystic, like, because obviously if I'm going to take the stuff literally, it's a bunch of bullshit and fairy tales. But let's talk about Jesus from historical perspective. I'm going to talk about him as a Jew, what I read about him. Messiah or Mashiach, like we call Messiah in our Hebrew language, we call Messiah Mashiach, supposed to come from King of David, supposed to be the direct descendant of King David. Jesus Christ was actually the direct descendant of King David, 26th generation after him. 27th generation, mind you. What's the significance of 27? 2 plus 7 is 9. 9 is a magic number. You know, I remember my boss years ago was talking about it, and he was saying, you know what, my favorite number is 9. Because 9 is a magic number. It's like, let's say, you're going to multiply 9 by any other number. For example, 4. 9 times 4 is 36. 3 plus 6 is 9. You know? Or you do anything with 9, like you multiply it by any number. And then the number which you're going to get, you're going to add up the digits of that number. It's going to be 9. There is no other number which does the same thing. No other number. You know? 9 is like the number of infinity. In a way, it's a number of death too. You know? Numerology. That's why I was watching that video too about Lisa Lopez, the documentary. And she was talking about Supernova. And she was talking about One because her album dropped on August 16, 2001, and she said it's one because it's going to drop like a bomb because she added up 1, 6, 2, and 1. But she forgot one little detail. There is 8. And it changes the whole thing. You're going to add it up. 8 plus 1 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1 is going to be 18. 18. 1 plus 8. 9! And that was the only album she made. So really, it was not like one, the album's gonna drop like a bomb. No, it's 9. And then after that, 7 months later, she had her car crash. April 25th, 2002. She made this album, it was a great album, and then that was it. You know, that makes me think that we shouldn't be afraid of death. Life is like a playground. We're here to produce something, to do something. You know, you are who you are. You're here to bring in the world something which nobody else brought. I don't care about anything else. It's all bullshit. Shouldn't be afraid, shouldn't be worried. Because the end's gonna be the same. Life is like a video game. Get the highest score. That's why, like, we try not to care about nothing. Should be afraid about nothing. And then people telling me, don't do this, don't say that. Bullshit. We have our freedoms. We have our ways. We need to live by that. And we shouldn't resist our human nature because it's going to come out. And that's the truth about the Christianity, because it seems like Christianity is a religion where religion of acceptance. And no wonder Brother Nathaniel, who grew up as a Jew, became Orthodox Christian. No wonder he became that way. Because me growing up as a Jew, yeah, I can clearly see how if you grew up in this, with the slave mentality of Judaism or Zionism or Satanism, you know, which is not real Judaism either, which is like, you know, heresy, which Satanist of Jewish ancestry called Judaism, but it's not real Judaism. Because all of these people who call themselves Jews, they're just a bunch of Satanists, that's all they are. So, of Middle Eastern ancestry, but, you know, like I said, we all know that the real Mashiach is Yehoshua, so, or one of his direct descendants. So, I'm not subscribing to that. And, yeah. I can completely understand why Brother Nathaniel chose Orthodox Christianity. And he is so happy being there. When he was 20 years old, he decided to become Christian. And now he is 70, he is still Christian. And all he does is he is making these videos about Jewish people. And sometimes I'm thinking I want to donate some money to Brother Nathaniel's foundation. You need to check it out, you know. Brother Nathaniel, he got kicked out of Zionist owned YouTube because of his hate speech perhaps. But whatever all of these people hold hate speech, it's the truth. Besides, they're applying double standards. Trust me on that. All the Jewish people out there, like, they telling me, oh, you shouldn't trash talk black people, these people. Trust me. All the Satanists, they trash talk everyone. They just do it behind closed doors. And when it comes to me, I have a right to trash black people like that because of what they did to me. Otherwise, I wouldn't care. I'm not like a racist per se, like, even though people may look at me and say that I'm racist, but that I don't think of myself as that. But I'm just an isolationist. I believe that isolation is the key to peaceful existence. And I've seen how black people are. Most of them, yes, they are not that smart. I've seen black Hebrew Israelites, and they are very ignorant people, but they are very opinionated about who they are. But they don't know nothing, really. That's why I have an opinion of black people as that, you know. Not because I wish bad things for them, no. They deserve to live how they want to. And I'm all for black people getting money and living large and all of that. But they're just stupid and they're running them out too much. And they're creating a lot of problems because they're fucking stupid. That's all I think about some black people I dealt with. That's my personal opinion, based on my experiences dealing with them. If they just sit there and do them, that's okay. And I work with them too, you know, and I'm going to admit that. It was my fault. I was trying, you know, to work with them, to show them my way. But apparently, their purpose is one thing and my purpose is different. There is nothing they going to want to know from me. And definitely I'm not going to learn anything from them. Of course they think that they're better than me. but I don't think so. I think that bunch of stupid, ignorant people, you know? Not all of them, but a lot of people I dealt with. There are some intelligent blacks, but, you know, what I've seen from them, it's like, damn, definitely. And, yeah. But like I said, the worst people are, you know whom I'm gonna name. And sometimes I wish I was not Jewish either, because I don't want to associate myself with these people. I want to separate myself from all of that Satanism. And I know I'm a sinner too. I'm a selfish individual. And being selfish is a human nature. And that's okay. Nobody should feel bad about anything, about who they are, because it's not productive. It's not going to change anything. And what's the point? There is no point of feeling bad about yourself or feeling bad because you cannot fit in. Life is all about doing you and not caring. But a lot of times, people are not letting you to be you. Because there are rules, there are regulations, there are norms, and people are judgmental by nature. The very non-judgmental person, whoever exists, was our Lord Jesus Christ. And this is something which people need to learn from him and his philosophy. And that's why, like, I like his philosophy. And there are some Jewish Kabbalists, like Mikhail Lightman. I watch his videos also in Russian. He was a former Belarusian Jew who lives in Israel now. He's a Kabbalist, and he has very interesting views, which some people would consider anti-Semitic as well. But, and he is talking about, like, that selfishness is not good. We need to be selfless. But then again, selfishness is a part of our nature. So why should you be feel bad about who you are if you are selfish? If you enjoy being selfish, you just have to realize it and just go with the consequences of that. And understand that, yes, being selfish is going to make you be alone. But being alone is not necessarily a bad thing. People make it feel like it's a bad thing, but it's not. We just think it is good what's bad. Because we don't realize it at the time. And that is the truth, you know. And that's why, like, I like the Christian philosophy, because it seems like it's very, very real and applies to life and, you know, kind of therapeutic, kind of helpful. But the funny thing is that right now people like that, they've been persecuted. Like, this world is horrible. Just like when I talked to that guy, he said that, you know what? You just can't live in peace. But he said, still try to be a peaceful individual. And I'm like, yeah, I'm trying, but it's like, a lot of times I'm coming, a lot of times I'm thinking the shit's gonna go down. And now even more than before. Now it's even more than before. Sometimes I'm thinking I'm gonna lose it. And I just wanna run away. And some people are saying you're not gonna run away from yourself. You never, you go, you're gonna have problems. Whatever. Whatever meant to be will be. Thanks for watching.